hay egg salad. I eat your pussy, unlike DJ Khaled.
Welcome to the Chip and Cern Show, the podcast about everything and nothing at the same time. They were possibly separated at birth, only to be rejoined to create the sweet sounds that will caress your deepest cochlea. The show is real, random, rant-filled, and ruthless. Please be warned that this show may hurt your feelings, offend your grandma, and even kick your dead dog in the balls. So get ready, and let's get this shit started.
This shit is started. I am Chip.
I'm Cern.
And you are listening to the Chip and Cern Show.
Once again. Or for the very first time.
Mm. What we're not drinking for the first time is the Deschutes Fresh Squeezed.
We are definitely not drinking for the first time.
Fresh Haze IPA, rather.
Yes.
This is the last of it.
This is my fridge. Crutch for drinking, I would say. My go-to. My ace.
It's an easy drinker.
Easy drinker.
It's a Citra hops. Citra hops, I believe.
But White
Claw. It's not overly... It's not... Yeah, it's not a truly... I do feel like I am living true in it, though.
There you go. You staring
God
at the beer?
Damn, it's... I'm looking at the beer because it's so delightful. Now, we fancy ourselves... Cerny, would you say that the Chip and Cern Show has their finger on the pulse of what's now?
I would say that, yes. Right on the main artery.
On the jugular of the what's now.
There you go.
And the who's who. And what all the kids are doing. That's us.
What all the kids are doing.
So, now, you may have heard this song, this little ditty.
little ditty
called Old Town Road by Lil Nas X. And this old crusty white guy, Billy Ray Cyrus.
I think he has an achy breaky heart.
Achy breaky heart, yeah. He needs to go to the doctor because he's got an achy breaky heart. And that's the only thing he's got.
Yeah. Well, and a daughter that's not divorced?
Yes.
Yes.
But it's one of those things I feel like I'm oddly attracted to her because she's such a mess. That I feel
you could fix her.
Yeah, I could white knight her ass, not sexually, but well, I mean, anyway, I feel like I could fix her. Cerny had it right there. It's the anyway, it's like if I started dating Taylor Swift, she wouldn't have any songs to write because I would be so good to her. She wouldn't have any source material.
Or she would change the beat.
Yeah,
it wouldn't be about the breakup or the torment.
After my
it would be about the
yeah.
Okay.
Anyway. That was just my pompous statements. Now, there's a lot of artists with the Lil in front of their name.
Lil Wayne.
I mean, let's just see. I'm going to put it in to Spotify.
That's a good...
I'm just going to search Lil.
Lil Romeo?
Is he still around? Artists. Lil Grit, Lil Baby, Lil Wayne... Lil Skies, Lil Yachty, Lil Uzi Vert, Lil TJ, Lil Peep.
Never heard of it. No. Okay.
Lil Durk, Lil Pump, Lil Mosey, Lil Keed, Lil John.
There we go. That's the original.
Lil Dicky.
Oh, who's first? Lil John or Lil Wayne? Or Lil Romeo.
I haven't any. Lil Kim.
Okay. Well,
Lil Zan.
She may be one of the originals, actually.
Little Xan, Little Duke, Little John and the East Side Boys, King Little G, Little Got It. I mean, there's 20 more. So I don't. Do we need to change our? Do we need to be Little Chip and Cern?
Little Chip, Little Cern.
Yeah. Okay. Little Nas X, Old Town Road. Now this song set. Records.
Yes.
I think it was the highest. Breaks the record for most weeks at number one. It was the longest reigning hit in 61 years.
Wow.
It was the number one single in America for 17 weeks.
Now, did you enjoy this song?
I did.
Okay.
Now, what about you?
I did not, but that's okay.
Well, should we?
And it was quick. It was catchy enough, but it wasn't. It's just not my wheelhouse.
I mean, I would say this song is not my wheelhouse either, but it was. Now it had equal parts. I don't know if it was equal parts annoyingly catchy and like kitschy.
Yeah, it can get stuck in your head.
Oh yeah. Now we're playing it now.
Okay.
We'll have to stop it because at some point, you know, we'll get booted off whatever platform. Now this Lil Nas X, who sang the song, it seemed to be a one-hit wonder of sorts.
That's what
very
I picked.
Popular,
that's though. What I pegged it. Almost like a who would be Sir Mix-a-Lot, you know, like that was like a
okay,
great,
yeah,
you know, great
now,
song, but it was, you know, it's one.
Are you listening? We're listening to it now. Is the beat's okay?
Yeah,
the beat's good. Is it the lyrically it kind of got?
I think it's just so.
Or is it the Billy Ray Cyrus coming in?
Yeah, Billy Ray Cyrus is. I think it's just. I don't know what it is. I mean, it's kind of like, I think it's kind of clever. He's like, regulars on my booty or whatever, you know?
Yeah,
it's like,
yeah.
Oh, okay, it's kind of.
I think lyrically, and this isn't as a criticism, it's a little simple. Like, it has the rhyming
delightfully
scheme.
Simple,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah, very good, Cernan. Thank you. That's a perfect way to put it. It's not overly.
He's not trying to force words into.
You're not overthinking
fit,
about the words and trying to understand the meaning. It just, you're going to just ride your horse till you can't no more. And like, that's all that it is. There's nothing deeper than that. And when you're listening to some other songs that have like, you know, deeper songwriting, I guess, that yours like.
Or they're trying to, it drives me crazy when they're trying to force a word that clearly doesn't.
Oh,
rhyme.
Shoehorn.
Yeah, shoehorn, yes. One that doesn't really rhyme, but they just try to change the pronunciation to where it does rhyme. It's
ooh,
like, boo, boo,
that always,
boo.
I always kind of get the cringies when I hear that one. So Old Town Road here, it was 17 weeks. So that is 4+ months.
Yes.
As number one hit. I mean, that's pretty impressive on the Billboard Hot 100.
So it's 4 times 4.
Carry the
16. Oh, but we possibly have 1 month in there with an extra week. So yes. That's okay.
Now, between the remix and the regular version.
There's a remix?
Well, the remix is the one everybody knows, but then this is the OG version. I mean, it's pretty similar.
Yeah.
Now, it also peaked and hit the country charts. Because it had Billy Ray Cyrus on it, which I appreciated, and the Wranglers on the booty and that sort of thing.
I think I saw this meme where it was like, who would have thought in 2019 you would see Billy Ray Cyrus get a standing ovation at the BET Awards?
Yeah. That's pretty funny. And the part that I liked about it was that how it turned the country thing on its head a little bit, even if it was maybe only on the charts for a couple weeks. Like,
yes,
you have a black guy who's a hip-hop singer or whatever genre hip-hop I would say, and he ended up he came out as gay.
Yes.
So you had a gay African-American hip-hop singer topping your country charts, like
into the country. Yes,
the fact that I know that probably irked a lot of people makes me root for the guy.
Yeah, I do. I think part of what bugs me is because of the whole country.
And country's closer to hip-hop now, or like radio mainstream country is closer to hip-hop now than.
I mean, since T. Swift broke in today.
That's true. Now, so we're dissecting the Lil Nas X.
Okay.
His newest song dropped.
I have not heard this.
You've not heard this, sir.
No, so this will be fresh to me.
Okay, this the song is called Panini.
Ooh, I like a panini sandwich. Okay.
A little whistling to start. The song's just over 2 minutes only.
Okay. Short and sweet.
It's a dreamy. Wasted on a genie. I got fans finally. And she wanted
me to see me. Panini, don't be meanie. Okay.
Don't keep me teeny.
Okay. It's not as catchy as Old Town Road.
Here's the hook.
Okay.
Hey Panini, don't you be a meanie. Thought you wanted me to go. Why you trying to?
So that is 54 seconds of a minute and 54 second song.
Okay.
So we heard the hook. Now, Cerny, are you smashing or trashing this?
I'm trashing this one.
Oh, Jesus. Now, the beat, I think, is catchy.
Yeah.
And I don't know if he's making his own beats or this is his thing. Lyrically, it's a little soft.
Yeah. Panini, don't be a meanie.
Don't be a meanie. Why are you making me so teeny? Now, I don't... Is there another sandwich he could have went with that...
Hey, Reuben.
Hey, Reuben. Why you... Let me see them boobins. I don't know. What do you... Where do you go? Hold on. Okay, let's think about it a little bit. Now, we just had our top 15 sandwich.
Yes.
Something about, is there any grilled cheese in there, potentially?
Hey, grilled cheese.
Hey... Grilled cheese.
You making me wheeze?
Why don't you suck on these? These nuts. That could have been a line that he could have taken. Okay, what was another popular sandwich?
Oh, he could just.
Is there any BLT?
Hold on, I got an idea. So let's hear it. These nuts.
Okay.
Peanut butter. You start going through sandwiches. You start going through the top 15.
So he's just going through a sandwich song. I'll give you some PB and these nuts. Okay, now BLT, why don't you suck on me?
There you go.
Okay.
Club sandwich. No, just club.
Club. We might be at a loss. Yeah. I won't club you, I think would probably be a good. Oh, Chris
flub,
Brown.
Club, club.
Yeah.
Chub. Oh, wait. We're
gonna close it. Okay. Hold on. Let's workshop this, Cerny. Let's get some inspiration. Hey, club, why don't you slob on this chub?
There we go.
Okay, that's good. All right, next sandwich. Pulled pork. Oh, that's pork, porkia. That's, is pork, that a little too easy?
A little too easy, maybe pulling.
Pork. Mm. Oh, hey, pulled pork. I
suck on my dork. Okay.
Hey, pulled pork. I'm going to boink Bjork.
There we go.
And she could do, it could be featuring Bjork. Is she alive still?
I don't know.
Oh, man. What's a Bjork song? B-I- How do you spell that?
Oh, spelling's not my own.
Yeah. Oh, her name is Bjork Bjork. She's Icelandic.
No.
She's alive and kicking, 53. She'll be 54 in November.
She's like 53. We're like, is she alive? Jesus. Okay.
I don't know if she had any substance.
True.
Now, should we listen to Bjork songs or? All right. Top sandwiches. Now, we got to go.
So there was the turkey, the ham,
mm-hmm.
grilled cheese.
Wow. The 12 best sandwiches, the grilled cheese. I think why don't you suck on D's?
There
you
is go.
That's I mean that's kind of the way to go.
That writes itself.
I mean we can't do all the work here, Lil Nas X. The classic Cuban. Cuban. Now there is the muffuletta sandwich, which has muff in it.
There you go.
Bon me. Oh, there's got to be. Take like a Vietnamese angle on it. Bon mi. Well, you can't say me and me like bon mi, sit on me, or
sit
fuck
on,
me.
Sit on thee.
Ooh, there we go. Cerny. Hamburger, hero. the meatball. There's, you could just entendre the shit out of it with the meatball sub. Okay. The cheese steak.
Steak.
You make no mistake, you're my cheese. Oh, no, you can't. That's I don't like the steak and steak. Lobster roll. Chicken pesto panini.
Oh, well, don't be a meanie.
Don't be a meanie. Hold on, we got something here, Cerny. Keep going. Why you make me so teeny?
Yes.
Okay. Now, these aren't, these are how to make the dish sandwiches. I just want to leave your website. I don't want to click a fucking survey. All recipes. Fuck off. 15 best sandwiches. What we need to find is our last podcast.
Oh.
Or not our last one, but you know.
Yeah. I got it right here. Let me get it.
I mean, it has a good beat.
It does. It has a good beat.
But, I mean, it's 2019. You got to have a song that's a little bit... And there's a lot of auto-tune going on.
I think that's... I get kind of jarred with the auto-tune.
Like, you're not sure what's real anymore?
Exactly. Well, when I hear it, it's like, I know it. You know, it's like you hear it, you know it, right?
Mufleta. Let me dive on that mufleta, I think would be the way to position that one.
Mufleta.
Roast beef. Put my dick in your teeth. Roast pork. I once fucked Bjork. Okay, Cerny. I mean,
okay, we're getting somewhere. Chip of Cern's next album.
Someone, you know what? It would be great. Like, you know, the likes of Adam Carolla and Joe Rogan have all these super fans that are more talented than us.
Oh, yeah.
And they like chop together and they would like auto tune or like do some cool animation. This is what we would need for our, not Old Town Road, but Panini remix. Poor boy. Ooh. That's tough. Pastrami on rye. And then you'd have to reference the
like
other.
Maybe like something about.
Pastrami on rye. I won't jizz in your eye.
There you go.
French dip.
Okay, I got from our pod.
Okay.
Okay. Grilled cheese number one.
What was the grilled cheese?
Number one.
And
suck on these.
Suck on these. Get on your knees for this grilled cheese.
Grilled chicken.
Give my dick a licking.
There you go.
Okay.
Turkey. Give my dick a jerky.
Oh, there we go. Give my dick a jerky. God, we gotta remix this up, sir.
Roast beef.
What was that? Oh, you got that roast beef? I want to smell your queef. Getting vulgar.
Ham.
Yes, and ma'am.
There. BLT.
What did we say about BLT? We couldn't think of anything for that.
Couldn't BLT. Oh, why sit on the.
Sit on the. Yeah, okay, that's
club.
What it was.
Club.
Yeah.
Club.
A club sandwich.
Oh yes, but the chub, right?
Yeah, something about the chub. Okay.
Bacon.
I'll make your booty ache it. That's it.
That's it.
That's it.
So the next one is, well, we can do PB&J.
Oh, wait, hold on. Now, the bacon one's the way he should make a new song. The bacon.
Okay, that's it.
You got the booty aching. You make my dick shaking. And you could do.
So the top eight will be a song.
Okay.
And then the rest of it will be a separate song.
Okay.
There we go.
Okay. I want to hear more. This is
so PB&J or peanut butter and jelly. So we get so you could pick whichever one rhymes better. So you could be PB&J.
PB&J.
We're going all the way.
Going all the way with the blow J.
Oh, I like it.
Okay.
Then we got pulled pork.
We fucked Bjork.
There we go.
I mean, you got to go with that one.
You have to.
And she'll be, oh, you know, what's a Bjork song sound like, Cerny?
Let's hear it.
I don't know. Wow, she's... okay, the top Bjork song is called, at least on Spotify, Army of Me.
Okay.
And let's listen to this. Let's see. Whoa.
This is a little wild.
I know. I wasn't prepared for this, Bjork.
Okay. We're still in the intro.
Still in the intro.
we're still trying to get
there. It sounds like a lot of synthesizer, yeah.
Standing up.
Stand up. I don't know. I'm kind of feel like I'm being like
accosted.
Yeah. Very heavy, like.
She's 53 making the song. Well, I guess it would be like an 80s.
Yeah.
So
I feel like I was in Jonestown or something.
Yes. I didn't like that.
No.
Okay, next.
So I don't know where she would really fit in, but.
Besides on our list.
Yeah. Besides on her. Yeah.
Tuna.
Okay. Hold on. I got to listen to the Panini song again to get me back in the.
Get you back in the zone.
Yeah. There's something there around. Hold on here.
Okay.
Okay. It's got a good. Tuna?
Tuna.
Hey, tuna. I'm gonna.
Put it in ya?
Put it in ya, or. Okay, here's the hook. Hey, tuna. I really wanna do ya. That's the only thing I could think of.
Okay, that's a good one.
Or I'm gonna do ya.
I'm gonna do ya. There we go.
In the. Cuda. Oh, there we go. Okay, there it is. Okay. It just took an extra second, but we got it.
This is a genius happened, everybody.
Yeah.
This is a tough one. Egg salad.
Oh. Egg salad.
I don't know.
Ooh. What rhymes with salad? Alad?
That's what I was saying, Alad.
Hey, egg salad. I fuck better than DJ Khaled. We the best.
And another one.
And another one. Oh, no. Hold on.
Okay.
Hey, egg salad. I eat your pussy, unlike DJ Khaled. That's it right there. That's a fucking roast track, too.
That is right.
That's a roast track.
That's true, because we have evidence that he doesn't.
Hey, egg salad. I eat your pussy. I'm like DJ Khaled.
And then we have meatball next.
You can't go with the ball, lick the balls or anything.
No.
Meatball, I'll give it to you all.
There you go.
The 5-inch Grinch.
And then our last two. So the second to last, the Ruben.
14 and 15?
Yes.
What did we say the Ruben was?
I don't think we...
Do we need more inspiration, Cerny?
Let's hear it.
Okay.
Ruben. Ruben.
Hey, Ruben. Let me... I couldn't.
A tough
nothing,
one.
Nothing came up right ahead.
Ruben.
Boop. Boobin? Oh, yeah. Right. That's something about boobin. Hey, Ruben.
Let me see your boobin?
Let me see your boobin or stick my dick between your boobins. Hey, Ruben. Let me. Hold on. Hey, Ruben. Let me sniff your poonin'.
Poonin? Okay. Poonin could work. Okay.
Okay.
Sign off. Okay. I mean, he said, what was that?
You're a meanie.
Yeah, and why are you making me a teenie? So
okay,
we're well within the guidelines.
Creative differences at this point, huh?
We're splitting and finally,
okay,
French dip.
Easy. Yes. French dip, just the tip.
Little Nas, we see your panini. Yes. We raise you 15 sandwiches.
15 sandwich songs. We can do an album just called The Fucking Beach Hut Deli. French dip? Put it in just the tip?
Just
what do you
tip.
Think? Okay.
Oh, hey. Yeah.
Hey, French dip. How about just the tip?
There you go.
Okay, we got it. Cerny. We got a fucking hip hop album on
we
our
do.
Hands.
We got auto tune, so we can make it ourselves.
Now with the intro and the outro, we really only need one kind of course, and we could just repeat that a second time, and we can get a minute 54.
Oh yeah, we do have a whole like a 15 album track right here. Right.
Okay. Some of them need more work than others, but I think
a little polishing. We'll say a little polishing.
A little polishing, but
maybe we'll have our Joe will come in and like. Featuring Joe. Oh,
that man's had a sandwich in his life.
Possibly as we speak.
Yeah. Wow. I don't know. So I guess Lil Nas X, what do we think? The panini song.
I mean, the beat's catchy, but.
I think the egg salad sandwich. Hey, egg salad. I'll eat your pussy unlike DJ Khaled.
That's hard. That's our leader. That's leader. That's
like track seven, maybe.
But I'll be like, you know, like on the on iTunes for like popularity. That'll hit the bar.
Oh yeah,
that'll be maxed.
That will be, and then DJ Khaled will have to clap back, which will boost our cred, and it will
absolutely.
He'll like
and then
boost
we'll do a
up.
Collaborative piece after that.
Oh, like a like come a, together.
Yes, like a.
A repair track.
Olive branch. Like we'll like oh. have to come together, and we'll have to.
What's make an olive mess. Sandwich? Olive tapenade, which is in a muffuletta.
So today I had olive bread. Delish. Oh, delish.
With sourdough?
No, it was like, yeah, it was like a sourdough bread, but it was like olives in the bread.
Yes.
It was, ooh.
What was our muffuletta?
I can't remember.
Let's roll the track back. Muffuletta, because we'd have to extend the olive branch and then to make DJ Khaled could be featured on the muffuletta sandwich.
That's true.
So our album already has a feature from DJ Khaled because we roasted him, but then we have a olive branch on the muffuletta track. Then Bjork because of pulled pork.
Yes.
And then, you know, we can maybe find... We should get DJ Khaled's wife on the egg salad roast track if she would have it, but I don't
yes.
know. Well, anyway, I will say... Chip, personally, I'm a fan of the Lil Nas X. I like what he's doing, and he seems to be a positive guy.
Yeah, I don't.
You know, maybe his songwriting, he needs
it's
a
It's not in my wheelhouse, but I don't hate what he's doing. It's just, you know, I don't, it's like, it's a, it just because I don't like it doesn't mean I don't, you know.
I wasn't implying such
I appreciate
things,
it.
Right?
I appreciate it. But it's not, I mean, Panini wasn't. I mean,
do you want to listen again?
No.
Panini, you're
a meanie.
You're a meanie. Why you make me so teeny? Don't you be a meanie.
Kind of keep me teeny. Keep me teeny.
Why are you trying to keep me teeny?
Hmm.
Mm.
Interesting.
Now, as Chip and Cern, if we've pointed out to Lil Nas X, there's other sandwiches that could have lent itself to maybe a more expansive song.
Yes.
Grilled cheese, good on your knees. I mean, we've already went over them. I mean, why don't you tweet us your favorites?
Yes. Now, if we miss a sandwich, you could tweet us as well. What's your favorite sandwich?
I don't know.
Just tweet us a sandwich.
Yeah.
And we'll come up with a good song.
We'll spit. I mean, I think the...
spit. It reminds, we'll spit it reminds it. Me of... side note. Dave Chappelle, where he did like the Real World, or not Real World,
Cribs.
No, he did like one where they were like in the studio with Wyclef. Spit some of this hot fire, man.
Oh, so he was being his white guy?
No, he was being I forget the fucking guy from whatever it was. It was Dave Chappelle, but he was doing it was like an MTV show at the time. It was like Puff at that time, Puff Daddy or P. Diddy's.
Diddy or whatever it was.
Yeah, you want some of his hot fire, man? Dylon.
Okay. Now, if you want to hear some of these clips after and send them to your friends just like you do with the memes, like the kids are doing with the memes, you check out our Instagram page.
Absolutely.
You check out our Instagram. Instagram. I guess we should say.
Handle.
And follow hashtag us. Live truly as well.
Absolutely. And if you...
Does the shoots have a...
They're not cool.
No, they don't have a hashtag on their beer.
Get on it. Get on the shoots. Now, if Instagram isn't enough and you want to follow us on Twitter or Facebook, or if you want to send us an email, just chipandsternshow.
Old school.
chipandsternshow@gmail.com or just chipandsternshow at Twitter, mm-hmm. Facebook, Instagram. We're all there. Mm-hmm. We will reply to anybody that comes in. I promise you, it is us. We do not have assistants.
Yeah, or interns. But if we'll reply back, so we won't be a hey panini, and we won't be meanies, and we'll try to keep you so teeny.
Always. If you want stickers or whatnot, just let us know. We'll send it to you. No problem.
Exactly what Cern said. Tell us your favorite sandwich. And your favorite sandwich song. Absolutely. Until next time, I'm Chip.
I'm Cern.
Cheers.